Welcome students. Today we are talking about the environmental impact assessment and management. Okay, so till now we are seeing about what is environmental impact, what is the basic concept, what are the features, what is the element, IEE, EIA report, how to make it, and what are the objectives, what are the factors that will affect the EIA. And we saw what is the impact, what are the different types of impact, the assessment, the analysis of impact. And we saw based on this how to make a base plan, and from the base plan how to identify the study area and what are the parameters that we have to take into it, and who are the persons who will be there, how to form a study team, preparation of terms of reference, TOR, which is an important document from the government point of view, and we will prepare a EIA report. And for the EIA report preparation, we saw what are the things that we have to take into account, and we saw what are the draft environmental impact statements and what are the final environmental impact statement. In the draft environmental impact statement, we will have all the possibilities, all the alternatives will be there. In the final environmental impact statement, we will conclude that this is what we are going to follow. Okay, and the last class we saw about the life cycle assessment, where starting from the raw materials till the end and again coming back, recycling everything, how this EIA is going to impact. That we saw. Today we are going to see about the another important topic called as the environmental management system, EMS. Okay, so what is environmental management system? Is a system and a database which integrates procedures and processes from training of a personnel, monitoring, summarizing and reporting of specialized environmental performance information to external and internal stakeholders of a firm. I repeat again, it is a system or a database, a management system or a database from which what and all we can learn, who, what are the processes that are included in that is there, even from the training of a personnel, what is the monitoring process that I am going to adopt, how I am going to summarize it. Okay, and what are the reports that I have to submit? What are the reports I am going to submit, and also specialized in environmental performance, particularly with the basic to EIA, environmental, what are the reports that I am going to submit? That is the most internal and the external stakeholders. Who are the internal stakeholders? They are the direct persons, okay, maybe the owner, okay. They may be the owner or the shareholders, right? They will come. Okay, direct owners, shareholders. Okay, they will come. What are they? Who are the external persons? Mostly the persons who are indirectly involved. That is the people around the place. Okay, people who are working and who will be benefited by this process. Okay, these are all coming under the external stakeholders. So, okay, so how will you do it? Okay, so it is a framework that helps an organization, why it is needed means to achieve its environmental goals through consistent review, evaluation, improvement of its environmental performance. So if there is anything that actually whatever we are putting in the paper or reports and everything that we are expecting, these are the things that may happen. But after that, when we go for actual work process, then we know that we are lagging in something. Some process is very sensitively affecting the environment. At the places, we have to stop and we have to think what are the things that is very sensitively affecting that, and that we have to take into it, and that we have to perform performance appraisal we have to do, and that to improve that performance, environmental performance, this EMS is very important because it is a continuous process. It is having its database. So we will think what is the previous month, what is the previous year, what is happening this year, we can what is happening. Like that throughout the life cycle, we can have a constant review, right? It is a critical review or positive review, we will have a constant review and consistent review. Not only constant, it is also a consistent review that is evaluate and identify the opportunities for improving and implementing the environmental performance of a project, right? Okay, organization project. The EMS itself does not dictate a level of environmental performance that must be achieved. And each organization is tailored. That is, each organization will have its own environmental goals, right? The goals will be differ for a, the goals may be different for a paper industry or a mall. So whatever the project it may be, the goals are different. So each organization, each industries or each project, it will have a different goals. So the organization CMS is tailored. It is not a ready-made one, it is tailored. It will be an asset to the organization, and its own individual objectives and targets it will be meant to. That was we have to check. Okay. So the next one, it is that to increase, that is the goals of EMS, the main goals of EMS is that to increase the compliance and the reduce the waste products. To reduce the waste, na, to reduce the effect of the particles, waste particles on the environment. What is the compliance? The act of reaching and maintaining the minimum legal standards. Okay. Actually, EIA, I told you 1994 when it was there, and after that also 2016 everything, it was very stringent. Okay. So it has to be adopted and it has to be regulated, it has to be followed. So reaching and maintaining minimum legal standard has to be maintained. For example, okay, so when you are going in for putting the waste materials into the river, okay, so there is a minimum standard of BOD to be followed, COD to be there, okay, BO that should be there. These are all having a minimum standards. So it differs from industry to industry, okay. So this standard has to be, at least the minimum standard has to be maintained. If there is a industry with air pollution, we have to check whether that it has following a very minimum, that is the standards, okay. Though it should not have any complaint, and it should not, the government should not go for any fine with that industry that they have waste product, this is what they are doing, they are violating the EIA rules and they will put fines. Though should not face any fines, and government interventions should not be there in the operations. Okay, these are the things, compliance, they have to be there. What is the next one? It is the waste reduction. So waste reduction is to reduce the environmental impact, reduce the environmental impact on the of this project to the society. Okay, how to do it means, how EMS helps us to develop, implement, manage, coordinate, monitor environmental policies. By this it will have a, thorough database and thorough monitoring process. It will have a systematic process by which this waste reduction will be can be enhanced, and also the same thing, it will not find any effect on the EIA. So the waste reduction begins at the design phase and throughout the pollution prevention, and it will end up in the entire life cycle of the project. So it will be, the waste also will be reduced by recycling and reusing process. So the, this is what the, again I am telling, it is to increase the compliance and reduce the soil, that is the waste particles. So from this one, what we are giving now, we can increase the manufacturing of the industries, the effect of the industries on the environment, everything that we can go in for this process. Okay. So the next one we will go for this. What is this environmental things we will go for? The, what are the features? The first feature is that it is serve as a tool or a process to improve the environmental performance and information mainly. From the design, the pollution control and the life cycle, that is the waste minimization, recycling, the products, everything that will be taken. That is the life cycle process, the project it will take. It will start from design, pollution control, waste minimization, training, reporting to the top management, setting up the goals, and the entire process it will take. That is the first feature. The second feature is that provide a systematic way of managing an organization's environmental effort. So because we have first itself we told EMS is a system or a database which will monitor the day-to-day process. Okay, it has to be entered the day-to-day process. So it is a way of, systematic way of maintaining, why it is giving so much of waste on this day, why this is very effective, and that we can go in for. The third one is that actually whether the organization's overall management is structure is okay, right? So if there is any management structure has to be changed, that can be changed in the intermediate range because of this EIA, so that the long term process will be good. Okay. So the next one we will see, the and also it gives order and consistency for the organization to perform. Okay, so it will not have any deviations. The government interference can be minimized through the allocation of resources, assignment of responsibility, ongoing evaluation of practices, procedures throughout this life cycle assessment. Okay, so the next one, it creates environmental buy-in from management and employees and assign accountability and responsibility. This is very important. So the company, what is the accountability to EIA and what is its responsibility in reducing the waste and also recycling? Everything this EMS will be monitored. We can get it from it. Okay. The next one, it sets the framework for training, achieving objectives and the desired performance. So that it will be aim at reaching the goals. Okay. So reaching the goals. Okay. So the next one, it is the helps in understanding the legislative requirements to better determine a product or service impact on the society, its priority, its significance on the society. So if you are having a company, what it is, the effect on the society, that we can take it. And focus on continual improvement of the system. This is very, very important, right? So if there is a very continuous information of the system, we will know where the curves are moving out and where the curve is moving down. So there we can monitor it and we can make it set right. Okay. So this is very helpful to implement the policies and the objectives to be made, that the objectives can be met. Okay. So this is the reviewing and auditing the EMS to find future opportunities. Reviewing and auditing the EMS to find the future opportunities. The next one, it will be encouraging the contractors and suppliers to establish its own EMS. Okay, so what happens next? If these contractors and suppliers is also included in the EMS of a company or a system, means the entire system will work good. So it will be very good and facilitates e-reporting to federal, state, provincial, government, environmental agencies to direct upload. Okay, so these are the features of EMS. Next, we will see about the basic elements of basic elements of EMS. EMS is environmental management system. So it addresses its regulatory demands in a systematic and cost effective manner. That is very important, right? It has its own database. It records the day to day happenings of a project in its own database, and wherever, whenever the government needs, it will produce to the government in a systematic way, right? So systematic, so wherever the cost is very high, it will manage. When there is a impact is very high, it will manage. So it is a cost effective manner. This proactive approach can help in reducing the risk of non-compliance to the both. What are the both things we told, the goals of EMS is, one is compliance, the next one, it is to reduce the waste. So the risk of non-compliance can be minimized with the help of this EMS. And improve health and safety practices for the employees and the public. Okay. So how the health can be increased? Non-compliance and reducing the waste, everything. Reducing the impact of this project on the, environmental impact reducing. It will be helping in the increasing, the improving the health and safety practices of the employees and the public. Okay. So it also helps in non-regulated issues such as energy conservation and can promote stronger operation control and employee stewardship. Stewardship is nothing but the leadership. Okay. So it can be helpful in wherever the energy can be conserved, there we can go in for an energy conservation. Okay. So the next, what are the elements is that it will review the organization environmental goals. Okay. I have said that every company will set a goal, right? So to reduce the impact, what are the processes that I have to do? That is reducing the environmental impact. To increase the compliance, what are the things I have to do? Right? So this goals can be reviewed day by day or year by year using this EMS one. And analyzing its environmental impact and the legal requirements. What are the legal requirements? What is that given in the EIA, EC? That is whether it is compliant. Right? So that setting environmental objectives and target to reduce the environmental impacts and comply with the legal requirements. I am telling the same thing. It is analyzing, reviewing the goals, analyzing whether it is following the legal requirements and reducing the environment, analyze, then setting, that is practicing, put into practice. And the next one, the establishing, right? So reviewing, analyzing, setting and establish the programs to meet these objectives or target, okay? So the monitoring and measuring progress in achieving the objectives, ensuring the employees' environmental awareness and competence, reviewing progress of the EMS and making the improvement. These are the basic elements of the EMS. So we saw what are the features, what is the goal, and now we saw what are the basic elements of the EMS. Okay, so the next basic element we will see is that it is actually a system designed for to meet the regulatory and legislative system requirements, improve the control of the environmental impact, provide confidence to the customers that the products and service. This is the main thing for any company, right? It will have to produce the confidence to the customers that their products and services are manufactured with the least negative impact and on the environment. Okay. So nowadays all of you members and all of us are very cautious about the environmental, right? Okay. If there is a tree to be cut off, the people, even nowadays, they are ringing up to the concerned official department and saying that so many trees are cutting off here, you come and take action. And then we are also having so much of awareness towards it. Okay. So the next one, it is a basic element, is that the organization is a system designed to suitably accommodate the changing in the marketing trend, making trends, marketing trends, and they act according to it at updating the system. Okay, EMS also helps in updating the system and reduce the cost associated with the environmental liabilities and insurance, and gain public and media support. So wherever the customer support, the public support, and the persons who are working there, they will increase their stewardship of the persons and other things, it will be there. The next one, it is a basic element, is that the environmental legalization and the effect of the environmental effect associated with the company's activities. These are the things, okay, it will list. First one, it will tell what are the legislations that has to be followed for the company. Next, it will tell what is the effect of this environmental impact on the society. Third, it will be setting with the target, okay. So what is the target? Such that at the end of this year, the environment impact has to be reduced by 20%. Like that, they will have a target. And keeping appropriate records of the targets. To achieve the targets, what are the ways that I have to go? And the next one, they will go for a regular undertaking reviews so that this target will be achieved. This is the main elements of this EMS. Okay. So this is one of the main elements. Even if you are not forgetting the other points, you have to remember this point. That is that environmental legislation will be followed, and environmental effect of the company on the field, that is on the society, it has to be reduced, and it will target how much it has to be reduced, such as reducing the waste production by quantifiable amount, that's right, by 10%, not 100%, which is not relay, that is a real one, it should be a very real one, and keeping appropriate records and undertaking the regular interviews. Okay, so how this goes, elements will be done. It is done by creating a EMS model. This EMS model is a very common one, and it is also a very essential one. The fourth thing is to plan, do, check, act. Okay, so first we have to plan what we have to do. Right, after planning, so many of them will plan that today we have to do so many things, but we will not do. But it has to be, next step has to go where we have to do what we actually wants to do. Right, then we have to check whether what we are doing is right or wrong. The next, I have to act. If there is anything wrong, then I have to act. Again, if it is right, again I have to go. This is a process that is to enhance the EMS. This EMS acts on this fourth process. Plan, do, check and act. PDCA cycle. We call it as a PDCA cycle. The process of developing an environmental policy, planning the EMS and then implementing it. So here is this process of environmental legislation, effect, setting target, keeping appropriate, undertaking regular reviews only can be achieved by this PDCA. PDCA, can you tell again? PDCA. Plan, do, check and act. We will see one by one. Okay. So the organization first commits to an environmental policy and then uses its policy as a basis for establishing a plan. Okay, so all when they are going in for a EIA approval, the first thing they will give a plan to them. That is, these are the policies that we are going to follow. So that based on that policies, they will make a plan. Okay, so then next step is that after that making a plan, the organization evaluates an environmental performance to see whether that is achieved. Okay, the objectives and targets are being met. That is the doing, PDCA. So if again, if you are checking that it has done, the target has been met. The third thing that we will go in for this, a corrective action is taken. Okay, checking. Okay, whether this is going in the right direction. We have to have proper check then and there. After that, then I have to go in for what is the last one? PDCA, act. Right, plan, do, check and act. So I have to act whether this is reviewed by the top management, so EMS is working. And I have to revisit the environmental policy to check whether it is very going as usual. Plan, right, do, check and act. These are the things I have to follow. The next one I am going for this EMA model. Actually, it is, I told you now, it is planning, doing, checking and acting. The next one we are going for this stages. So, EMS stages are environmental management stages. Okay, it is one of the main thing and it is defined by ISO 14000. What is ISO? ISO means International Organization for Standardization. Last class itself we saw, right? ISO, International Organization for Standardization. 14000 is the main thing which will monitor the effect of the project on the environment. Okay, there are four things: commitment and policy, planning, implementation, evaluation and review. Okay, so first thing is the commitment and policy. Every project that is there, they have to have a commitment. That is, this is the policy I am having, this is a commitment, by this I am going to go along with it. After this commitment, I should go for a plan, right? So based on this commitment, based on the target, what I have felt, based on the target, I have to plan so that I can reach this commitment and policy. After planning, if I am going to do, nothing will work. So I have to go in for an implementation of the work. After implementation, I have to go for an evaluation. So evaluation is nothing but to whether we are going in for a right direction. Then I have to go in for the review, right? Whether it is any process has to be in play. I mean, everything is going on right. Anything can be modified. Anything can be revisited. Anything can be reorganized, right? Then I will go based on this. I will go for again the commitment and policy. These are the steps that is, have to go throughout to the continuous improvement. This will only helps in the continuous improvement. These are the stages. So we will see one by one. Commitment and policy is mainly done by the top management. Top management committed to environmental improvement and stabilizes the organizational environmental policy. This policy is the foundation for all the EMS, right? Environmental management system. The top management gives a policy, target, everything that has to be achieved for the environmental improvement. Okay, this is the commitment and policy given by the top management. The planning. So the planning will be done by the group of officials who are involved in the EIA operations. So first identifies the environmental aspect of its operations. Then it will find out what are the items that has to be taken care in order to reduce the EIA on the EIA effect on the environment. That is the effect of a negative effect. We have to identify the those items such as air pollutant or hazardous waste. Then we have to go in for the people's monitoring, and we have to say how we can reduce this impact on the people, impact on the environment, biological environment, on a historical monuments, everything I have to take. The next one I have to go in for example. You can see that a worker health or safety has to be met. And the next one, it is the implementation. So, in the implementation, you can see The organization will have a proper target and other things. It will involve so many things, the human, financial, everything. So then in implementing, this also has to be taken care of. Just like that, I cannot go for implementing. The economy of the things will be have to taken care. The health of the workers, everything has to be taken care. And the proper employee training and awareness has to be taken care by, and it has to be given to implement the proper policy. And this everything has to be documented in EMS. That is, the EMS is the, it is a database, right? So everything has to be documented, and we have to check what are the internal factors, external factors affecting the EIA, and it has to be implemented, right? And the next one is the evaluation. So the evaluation, we will be seeing whether the goal or the target which is set to by the industry, that is due for the environmental impact assessment, met or not. Okay, so the next one, the review. After all these things, then they from the EMS report, they will have a review system. Okay, so the commitment, target are met or not. If it is met, what is the thing that we can review? We can again, we can go in for revise and other things that we will be doing. Okay, so the for based on this, all these actions, we go for cost and benefit of an EMS. The internal, the staff management, time is also, this is a resources, time is also a resources. This is directly or indirectly based on the cost. The second one, other employees' time. Okay, so the workers' time, the management times, all the times, who is how many times you are taking for planning and implementing, that has to be taken. The external is the potential consulting assistance outside training of the personnel. Personal trainings, other things, the cost, that is the benefits that is happening, that is considered for the EMS, implementation of the EMS. Then potential benefits is the improved environmental performance, enhanced compliance, pollution prevention, resource conservation, new customer or market, and increased efficiency or reduced cost. These, all these points all, that is contribute to the cost and the benefits of an EMS. Okay, so the next we will see that the core elements of the EMS. Okay, so the core elements of the EMS is that, actually, where we have so much of alternative or so much of other methods for the implementation of the EMS, but we have to go in for a single best approach method, which will be considering the implementation cost and also what is the less effective of the that is the system, right? The that is in the environment, that has to be there. And also this environmental management system also looks into the core elements, right? So which are to be not to be changed. Some policies, some that is the method of production will not be changed, but it has to be enhanced by any other method. So which are it is for this can be enhanced is the first one, it is with the environmental policy. So in the environmental policy is based on ISO 14000, and this environmental policy differs from industry to industry. Okay, the based on the what is the project or what is the product that we are going for, and it will be throughout the life cycle assessment plan that we will have. Okay, and it will have a very broad goals, and this goals has to be targeted and achieved. The next one, environmental related organization structures. So the even in the that is any project, this environmental should be a part and parcel of this that is EMS plan. The next one we will see, this is the next one we will see the integration of the environmental concerns. You can see if there is a EMS model, we will have a management review, that is a checking and correction, action, monitoring, measurements, all these things, that is all these things comes under the EMS records. Okay, so here the first one, it is the management will take into an environmental policy, check whether the environmental policy, the goals are met or not. So for this, what they will do now, they will go for an environmental aspect, what are the legal requirements, what are the objective or the, that is the goals that has to be met, and what is the EMS programs that are established to monitor all these things. After these goals are taken, that is the planning that is made, then we go for the implementation, doing and checking. So the structure and responsibility, then next one, it is a timing awareness, communication, EMS documentation, control, everything will be taken care. Okay, so the next one, we will be going in for this checking and corrective actions, that is action, monitoring, measurement, non-conformance, corrective measure. The same thing, plan, do, check, TDCA, act. Again, this is a circle. And this also the planning, implementation, evaluation, review, commitment and policy. So, you can remember all these things. So, by this we are completing the first unit, right? So, we have seen from the environmental impact assessment, what is meant by environmental impact assessment, what is its features, basic elements, objectives, factors that is affecting, and we also saw about the what is the how to make a EIA report. And in today's class we saw about the environmental management plan. When we see about the environmental management plan, just remember four things: plan, do, check and act, TDCA. Okay, let us meet in the next unit. Okay.